हेलो, कैन यू हियर मी?
यस सर, वी कैन हियर यू।
यस सर।
लाइक एज पर द रूटीन, टुडे इज नॉट माय क्लास ना, टुडे इज डॉक्टर हजोंग्स क्लास। सर हैज आस्क्ड मी टू टेक रिगार्डिंग एनी एब्डोमिनल केसेस पर्टेनिंग टू द एग्जाम। सो एंड देन आई वुड नाउ हाउ इज योर प्रिपरेशन? यू गाइस आर रीडिंग थ्योरी
समटाइम्स सर,
एंड देन फॉर द प्रैक्टिकल, प्रैक्टिकल हाउ यू आर रीडिंग प्रैक्टिकल?
वी आर नॉट रीडिंग फॉर द प्रैक्टिकल सर।
Only theory you are reading. So basically you have to read regarding practical also, clinical cases bagira. We are also trying ki like, okay, like some theory assignments, then the practical assignment also will start giving you, okay? But from your side you have to keep reading any cases bagira. So like today I will take I'll talk about little bit about this one, like any acute abdomen pain. Okay?
Yes sir.
Okay, we'll talk little bit about the abdominal examination of abdomen, then slowly we'll go with the cases. Okay, behind me, can you see the white board?
No sir.
No, you cannot see. Okay, I'll try to align that camera for a white board. Can you see guys now?
Yes sir.
So today we'll talk about little bit about abdominal examination, okay? And we'll try to take slowly of a clinical classes. I hope theory you can read by yourself, but practically we'll try to do something. So today I'll talk little bit about mass in the abdomen, okay? Mass. Hey, suppose patient comes with a pain abdomen. Any pain abdomen patient, okay? We'll talk a little bit about a differential diagnosis for a mass in the right hypochondrium. Okay, this type of patient, they might come with a pain abdomen, or patient may not be having pain. Okay, and patient may come with a jaundice, patient may not come with jaundice, may or may not be coming with a jaundice. Patient may come with a mass, small mass, or patient may come with a lump. So in our mind, we have to have a differential diagnosis of masses in the right hypochondrium. So what will be the DD here, differential diagnosis? So if patient comes with a jaundice, okay, or without jaundice, without jaundice, with a pain, abdomen pain or no pain, okay? So patient might come with a pain abdomen, or may not even come with a pain abdomen. Patient may even come with a jaundice or may not come with a jaundice. Sometimes patient may even come with a jaundice with a pain, okay, plus minus this up, okay? Now when you have this type of patient in a casualty or an OPD, so especially in the right hypochondrium, so we have to keep in our mind ki what are the organs that is there in the right hypochondrium. Okay, so first thing you will be thinking of is, so DD you will be thinking of it is a, whether it's a GV mass, okay, or else like it is a liver mass, or it could be a biliary mass, okay. Now if patient comes with a jaundice, then we have to think more of a pancreatic mass or a biliary mass. Okay, pancreatic mass. Now when you talk about GB mass, patient will having a, like what are the conditions that will have a GB mass? Patient might have a empyema gallbladder, GV, or patient might have a mucosal or gallbladder, or patient might have a CA, malignancy of the gallbladder. Okay, when you have a patient like this and then you are thinking of a GV mass, then if you have to ask about the pain abdomen, the duration of the pain, eject site. So GV mass, it could be a mucosal, then it could be a empyema gallbladder, or it could be a malignancy of the gallbladder, or maybe if it is like biliary mass, when I say it could be malignancy of biliary 3, I mean cholangiocarcinoma vagra ho sakta hai with the jaundice, then could be a pancreatic head mass. Okay, so these, they may present with a pain abdomen, lump in the right hypochondrium, and also with a jaundice. Okay. Now, next is like when you have a mucosal of the gallbladder, you have to evaluate more of a patient regarding switching of a antibiotic, starting of antibiotic, or liver enzymes, pain,
or any comorbidities like diabetes, because these are the patient like who will be having a where you have to take a decision to operate or not to operate.
Okay, if there is a mucosal of the gallbladder and patient doesn't have a comorbidities,
then patient may not present with a jaundice. Patient may just have a lump in the right hypochondrium, and that lump will be a movable lump. It will move with the respiration. Okay. And one more thing is, like, if you don't treat the patient with the mucosal of the gallbladder, that will complicate into a empyema of the gallbladder. Now, empyema, if it is there, and even patient doesn't have a diabetes or comorbidities, you have to think of an emergency OT rather than keeping patient only on an antibiotic. Okay. Mucosal of the gallbladder, yes. Mucosal of the gallbladder, you can try conserve the patient, start on antibiotic, IV fluids, wagera, painkiller, wagera, dedo. Then, if it is patient is stabilized, you send all routine investigation and then plan for a elective cholecystectomy. Now, if it is empyema of the gallbladder, where there is already that collection in the gallbladder that is already infected, so you can empirically you can start an antibiotic, broad spectrum antibiotic, and if patient deteriorates or patient chances of deteriorating, you have to go with an emergency OT. You cannot keep on waiting for the patient to be normalized, and then decision has to be taken for an emergency OT. Okay. When you have mucosal or when you have empyema of the gallbladder, so other than routine investigation like CBC, LFT, KFT, electrolyte, wagera, especially mucosal and then empyema of the gallbladder, you can advise even a plain X-ray, chest X-ray. So that will sometimes that also will give an evidence like there is a collection of a mucus or there is a gas under the gallbladder. So organism that is inside the empyema gallbladder will be a gas-forming organism. So and then if it is a mucosal bagera ya fir gas bagera hoga, then you will be having a air fluid level in the gallbladder. Okay. Now carcinoma of the gallbladder may be like carcinoma of the gallbladder. Malignancy of the gallbladder will take in a separate classes. Empyema and mucosal, actually it may come as a short note. Okay. Separately, they might come as a short note, mucosal of the gallbladder or empyema gallbladder. Okay. Malignancy, carcinoma of the gallbladder will take in a separate classes. Today, we'll just describe broadly ki what are the differential diagnosis for a mass in the right hypochondrium. Okay. Now, mucosal and empyema gallbladder, do you have any questions for me?
No, sir.
You don't want to ask him anything. Okay. So, then we'll go with one is a malignancy of the gallbladder that will take in a separate class. Then we have a biliary mass. Biliary mass, actually, sometimes you may not be able to palpate, distinctly you may not be able to describe, yes, this is a biliary mass. Yes, if there is a cholangiocarcinoma or if there is a, obstructive jaundice, presenting with obstructive jaundice with some mass effect, then you might suspect of a cholangiocarcinoma or you may suspect of a cholangiocal cyst, the stage 5 bala. I mean, type 5 bala. Okay, or we call it as Carolis disease. Now, in those cases, you have to evaluate more regarding MR. You have to, other than CBC, LFT, KFT, and routine investigation, bleeding time, clotting time, you have to consider for MRCP, or you have to consider for even for ERCP in a good setup. Okay, so that is cholangiocarcinoma, if it is presenting as a right hypochondrial mass. Now, how will you differentiate between gallbladder mass and cholangiocarcinoma? So that will be a very big debate. If you have to say ki yes, this is gallbladder carcinoma or gallbladder mass, or this is a biliary mass or pancreatic mass. So there we can differentiate by you have to palpate, then you have to palpate and see, and then if the mass or the lump moves with the respiration, then we might consider ki yes, this could be a gallbladder mass. Okay. And another thing is if it is any gallbladder mass, they may initially stage they may not present with a jaundice. If patient has come with a jaundice, then most probably that could be a pancreatic mass or ampullary mass, or could be a cholangiocarcinoma malignancy, biliary malignancies or biliary mass. Okay. patient coming without jaundice and lump in the right hypochondrium, then you have to think of a more of a gallbladder rather than this one biliary. One more thing is like, see, that could be the whole thing could be key, like how will you differentiate now like liver mass and gallbladder. No, it's because like if we talk about the moving with the respiration, the lump or the mass in the right hypochondrium that moves with the respiration, then even with the liver mass, they will be moving with the respiration. If it is the distinct mass, liver, large liver mass and gallbladder mass, you may not be able to differentiate much if it is especially from the anterior side of the liver mass. Yes, there you have to think about the continuity, if there is any continuity with the liver mass, mass with the liver, or there is a discontinuity, or there is some margin where you can palpate your finger, or where you can insinuate your finger and then see, yes, this could be a different border or a margin you can get out of the lump or the distant mass. Then if you can get a distinct margin or distinct area where you can differentiate between the mass and the liver, then that could be a gallbladder. But if you cannot, the mass continues with the gallbladder, liver mass, then that could be a liver mass rather than any other mass. Okay. Now one more thing is again, the right hypochondrial mass can even be a cyst also can be have. Okay. Hydatid cyst ho sakta hai, amoebic cyst ho sakta hai, all those things. Okay. Liver mass, regarding that liver mass presenting with secondaries or multiple liver mass that can be presenting in the right hypochondrium, and then you can feel two, three masses of different sizes and in the right hypochondrium. So that could be a metastasis also. But distinctly, you may not be able to feel that way until unless it's too big or too large to palpate. Only when you go for a CT scan or MRI or MRCP, then you might able to say, yes, this could be a metastasis, or this could be a secondaries from anywhere else in the liver. Okay, so those things also you have to keep in mind. One more thing is like hepatomegaly as such, physiological hepatomegaly or pathological hepatomegaly also you have to keep in mind, okay, what are the infectious disease that causes hepatomegaly. So you need to know basically from the third semester onwards, you should be knowing where is the till where is the liver span, and then till where it can be, and when do we call as a hepatomegaly. Bedside, they may ask you what is hepatomegaly criteria or characteristic, how do you say it is a hepatomegaly. Same like splenomegaly, how do you define splenomegaly, how many times it should be larger than the normal, bigger than the normal, wagera. Okay, so that is regarding the liver mass, wagera. another one is like pancreatic mass or periampullary mass, and it could be some benign hyperplasia, or could be a benign tumor of the duodenum. That also can sometimes present in a inclined more towards the right hypochondrium. May not be exactly in the right hypochondrium, but in the epigastric and then more towards the right hypochondrium. Okay. Now another one is like periampullary carcinoma bagra. So these are very common site of present, common diseases which presents with a mass most in the epigastric region, encroaching or presenting along in the right hypochondrium mass. So periampullary carcinoma or pancreatic mass, that could be the one, another one that could present as a mass in the right hypochondrium. And another one is, again, you have to look for any other organ that can present in the same way in the right hypochondrium. So another one we have is that we have a kidney, retroperitoneum leak. So kidney mass also, again, you have to think about, even kidney also can be presenting as, kidney mass also can present if it is grossly enlarged, you know. Then sometimes they say sometimes colonic mass like malignancy of the right colon, like ascending colon or right hepatic plexure wala malignancy in that region, also can present with a this one in the mass in the right hypochondrium. And also like sometimes like pulled up cecum, we call it as pulled up cecum. Cecum also like a TB of the ileocecal junction. Sometimes they may also may present of with a mass in the right hypochondrium. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Ankit, you can hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So do you have anything to ask?
Sir, how to make it out if it's a colonic swelling?
Colonic swelling, from the history onwards, like you have to start asking the patient ki, how is the presentation. If presentation says ki, like first thing is like okay, male, female, aapko janna hai ki which were most common. Second one is like the age, you have to see ki, yes, like colonic mass, they may present mostly at the elder age group means like they may cross 40-50 years. Second thing is like bowel movements, you have to ask ki, okay, how is the bowel movement, whether they have been through like loose motion, or they have been through constipation, or they have been through absolute constipation or not. Second thing, like another one is like you have to ask about the passage of a blood in the stool, melina vagera aapko dekhna hai, stool mein aapko blood aa raha hai ki nahi dekhna hai, wo dekhna hai. Another one is like the look of the patient, cachexic look hai ki nahi, wo sab ek baar dekhna hai malignancy mein weight loss ka karan se. And another one is like that mass may not move with the respiration. When you think about the moment of the respiration clinically, like gallbladder mass, they may move, liver mass, they may move, but this mass may not be moving with the respiration. And also sometimes you may able to appreciate the bowel movements when you have a distinct presentation in the right hypochondrium, that lump or a mass. Okay. तो इस तरह से आपको डिफ्रेंशिएट करना है. देन अनदर हिस्ट्री लाइक ये आपका जो पर्सनल हिस्ट्री में वेट लॉस इज देयर नॉट, ऑल दोस आपको पूछना है. एनी टीबी वगैरह था कि नहीं पहले, वो पूछना है. देन एनी ब्लड ग्रुपिंग वगैरह पूछना है कि कौन सा ब्लड ग्रुप है. कॉलोनिक मैलिग्नेंसी देयर द हैपन टू बी मोर कॉमन इन ब्लड ग्रुप ए रादर देन एनी अदर ब्लड ग्रुप जैसे. ओके
सर. Yes, sir.
So these are just differential diagnosis we'll be keeping in our mind, and then like slowly we have to come to one diagnosis where we can have to say ki, yes, this is that mass. Okay. So har ek mass ka we will see the case study. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Do you have any questions for me?
No, sir.
Okay. Then. Then next we'll take up a pancreatic mass in the next class.
Okay, sir.
Okay, like have you done any presentation during the clinical posting, any gallbladder mass bagera, lump abdomen classes? What are clinical classes?
We have seen empyema.
You have seen empyema?
We have seen empyema.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
You make a list of cases which you have not seen in the world. Okay. So I mean like from the third semester to the eighth semester till the corona didn't come, to uska aap list banao ek bar ki like what are the cases you have missed to see. It's not that ki like okay, once you see any cases, at least once you discuss any cases, you'll have a little bit of a paint idea ki, okay, these are the presentation and this is how it looks like clinically. Now the cases which you have not seen, so we'll try to arrange those cases which we can at least send you some videos in the WhatsApp, or we can tell you what you can do for that cases. I hope thyroid is not seen. You have not seen thyroid?
No, sir.
So thyroid nahi dekha. Then varicose vein?
No, sir.
So thyroid ho gaya. Then varicose vein. Then breast dekha hai, breast, carcinoma breast?
Nahi dekha sir.
Can you guys hear me or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, then you do one thing, make a list of the cases which you have not seen, and then I will try to present the cases, and you guys can put me a question. Okay, so I'll try to present here whatever cases I have, or I'll try to write up the history vagera, और यू कैन ट्राई, समबडी कैन लाइक वी कैन डू वन थिंग दैट वे ऑल्सो कि लाइक ओके नेक्स्ट क्लासेस में चलो अंकित या अनिकित प्रेजेंट करेगा, फिर मलिम प्रेजेंट करेगा, या फिर रोनिया प्रेजेंट करेगा, तो नेक्स्ट में आप मान लो कि देख के भी प्रेजेंट करो, देन ऑल ऑफ अस कैन हैव सम क्वेश्चंस फॉर हर और हिम. व्हाट यू से?
ओके सर.
सो लाइक यू डू वन थिंग, यू राइट अप द केसेस व्हिच यू हैव नॉट सीन और व्हिच यू आर इंटरेस्टेड टू नो. ओके
ओके सर.
हां, देन वी विल ट्राई टू प्रिपेयर कि ओके हु विल प्रेजेंट व्हाट. ओके.
Okay.
I have not been assigned any of the much of the topic, but I'll try to cover up all those like operative procedures, then instrument bhi main try karunga, x-ray also I'll try to do. Okay. Specimen to I think like I can take classes for you, I think specimen, instrument wagera. I'll try to discuss all those things, all these things with the Noor sir, our HOD. Okay. And like I will try to come up with some solution how to continue our online classes, even for practical classes and for the operative classes, then instrument and X-ray scaling. Okay. So you make a list and then like please tell me ki what are the long questions or short long cases or short cases you have missed it and you really wanted to see. Okay.
Yes. Okay, sir.
Okay. So we'll end up today.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.